come and eat some dinner with me and all my friends. It'll be a party until the very end. Get your food hot and ready to begin, cause it's eating with Aoki, me and all my friends.
Your future dinner!
Yo, 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 yo! What's up, world? What's up, everyone? What's up, guys? How you guys doing?
Yeah.
Dude.
Yo, like,
this is crazy. We got the, like, I mean, we're all different artists. We're all different around the different parts of the world right now. What's up, Nick?
What up? What's up, neighbor?
I know, exactly. Okay, we got two Las Vegas people here. Will, where are you at?
I'm in Los Angeles, my bro.
That's my old home turf, too. Maluma, where are you at?
I'm in Colombia, bro. Medellin.
That's dope. Agnez Mo, where are you at?
Indonesia.
Yeah. Jakarta?
In Jakarta?
Jakarta, yep.
Nice.
Oh, man. I love it there.
Lay, where are you at, Lay?
Yeah, I'm in Shanghai right now.
Dope.
Wow.
That's crazy, man. We got the world right here, and the world's watching us right now on the stream. This is awesome. We're all together. I appreciate you guys all joining me in this Neon Future dinner and being on the album as well, Neon Future 4. It's been a pleasure to work with all you guys. But let's get into it, guys. Quarantine.
Quarantine!
That's what we're living in, guys. We're in a quarantine. There is no other time in the world where we would be sitting down talking virtually because we're all so busy touring. We're all so busy making music. But it's just a crazy time. You know what I mean? Like, and I think one of the things I've been looking at when I'm going through all the tweets is the fans want to know what we're all doing. Fans want to know how we go through the day being creative, or just what are we doing during this time. Nick, what are you up to?
Well, I'm celebrating Easter by eating these Reese's Pieces Easter Bunny candies right now.
Nice.
And I'm trying not to eat too many of them. But hopefully we'll be able to get back on stage. No, seriously, I mean, we're just all trying to, you know, make the best of our time. I'm sure like every one of us out there, you know, trying to just work out and, you know, do things like online, whether they're like YouTube videos or, you know, different things, yoga, you know, indoors, or, you know, just, and I got two kids, so I'm like raising them, and that's definitely tough because they can't even be in school right now,
right?
You know, and but I find myself just like literally like doing dishes. I never knew how much I actually love doing dishes, and you know,
wow.
So I'm just domesticated, so right now, so is what it is.
Well, I mean, you have a gaming headset. You game too?
I'm trying to. By the time the day is over, I get really tired. You know, one thing we're doing is there's a thing called Jackbox.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Jackbox TV.
Yeah, yeah.
Like Quiplash and all those things.
Dude, it's amazing. It's
we
the
play
best.
Those. So, like, you know, by the time, you know, so stay up to like 11, 12 o'clock, try to get up on the next morning. But yeah, I love gaming. I love the new Call of Duty game.
Yeah.
Dope. Yeah, so I'm all gamed out right now.
We'll have to game later then, because I'm playing Warzone myself too.
Nice.
Lay, what are you up to?
Yeah, I've been filming a reality show in China for a while. So it's about the producers. So I need to make a lot of tracks for that. So I spend a lot of time in the studio and making some stuff.
You're making beats all the time?
Yeah.
Yo, can you play one?
Yeah.
Yo, dude, the fans are going to go crazy for this right now. Brand new Lay Zhang music right now. Right here, yeah, right here. Holy shit. Let's go.
Okay. It's not a final version. It's not a final version, so just listen to this.
Lay, you gotta turn it up, man.
I'm like,
you gotta turn it up. Put it by the speakers. There we go. Lay, we can't hear it. We can't hear Lay.
Oh, there we go. Okay. Oh, yeah, there we go. Oh, wait.
It's like it's like a teaser.
Yeah, I know, right?
It's a proper teaser. Yeah, yeah. Yo, I like that face though.
Yeah.
Lay, we couldn't hear it, man. We couldn't hear it. Yeah, dude, it was like phasing out or something. I don't know, you know.
Wow. He was so excited dancing and whatever, and we're like, bro, can I hear it?
Yo, once you made that face, I was like, oh man, I want to hear that one part when you're just like, oh.
Hell yeah.
Oh, I thought it was dope. Sorry. From what I heard.
We'll have to do that again though. We'll fire. We'll come back to that. Maluma, what are you up to?
Well, bro, I'm in Colombia right now. I'm in my house, in my living room. It's been kind of crazy, you know, but I feel very grateful because outside of my house I have like a little garden, and I also have like some activities that I can do inside my house. So, I mean, I'm never at home neither. So I'm feeling like for the first time in my life, I'm really enjoying every corner of my house. You know, like a bunch of activities that I didn't do before. You know, so
right.
It's cool. I was in Europe before this. I was in Greece when all this shit started and whatever. And I took the plane. I just came right away to Colombia because I really wanted to share time with my family, you know, be here with my mom, with my sister, and just get close to them, you know. It's very important to feel at home with your family in this time we live in all. But yeah, I'm being creative too. I released a song like 3 weeks ago, something like that. So yeah, I've been working also my new project, my new album that I was still want to release this year. So yeah, bro, it's been very creative and very, very, very spiritual too, you know. It's been cool.
That's dope, man. Agnez Mo, what about you?
Man, like, this is just much needed, you know. Like, I mean, I live in LA and I didn't remember when was the last time that I spent, you know, more than 5 days in Jakarta with my family. So like they're super happy, you know, like. True. And it was crazy because like I had to do live show on TV, and then, you know, we couldn't cancel that, so we had to do it without audience because of the social distancing and everything, and it felt different.
Yeah,
you know, it felt different. It's like you gotta hype it up, but then like there's no audience.
Yeah.
And then how you like stuff of like people, you know, energy. So right. it's interesting. And then we have to move one of the live sessions in my living room and stuff like that, but it's how creative we can be, you know. I just feel like we're so lucky being in this industry.
Right exactly.
But I mean, I think I'm pretty much trained for this because I'm an introvert, so I'm like, yeah, like finally, you know, I don't have to travel around the world.
What about you, Will?
I'm just here, just finishing in quarantine, obviously. You've been to my studio, so I'm just here by myself, and just finishing up the last touches of the Black Eyed Peas new album. We just released a song that we have with Ozuna 2 days ago.
I saw
that. And it's crazy. We had like 5 million views in a day, which is nuts.
Yeah.
Mama Chita. So I'm gonna play. I'll just play a little clip right quick here.
Yeah.
Baby, ven conmigo, baila, baila, música de tío, le la mamacita, mi puto me sube, tío, diamante, le gusta el cuerpo al oído, le la oído. Mamacita, mamacita, que bonita, mamacita.
have the air horns.
I got the air horns.
Rip that, dog.
Will I am.
Yo, man.
Yeah, so I'm really excited about that, man. Like, this song is really, really fresh. Coming off of Ritmo, Ritmo was really cool with Balvin and just keeping it, like, keeping the momentum going.
Yo, Will, you've been working with every Latin artist. What about me, bro? Like,
wait, bro. The first Latin artist that we worked with was Maluma, bro.
Yeah.
Last year's Super Bowl, I saw Maluma at Super Bowl, and I'm like, oh, shit, that's the guy that all my family's talking about. That's Maluma right there. I swear to God, bro. 2 weeks later, he came to L.A., and we recorded a couple of songs. Yeah.
You have the vocals, actually.
Yo, bro, I gotta show you. You think these ones are dope? Bro, the one we did is crazy.
I've been waiting for it, bro.
Let me jump on this record too, man. Like, I mean, you keep talking about it. I gotta get on this shit too. I got my studio out here. I can work on that beat.
It's a dope studio too.
Yo,
your studio's crazy.
Yo, that video looks like Wes Anderson. Like, you know,
very inspired by Wes Anderson.
That Royal Tenenbaums, like, you know,
yeah,
like, that big outfits time. That's dope. It's dope. Dope. Nice. That's dope, guys. It's cool to hear the beats. Lay, I want to hear that beat. I think the fans were like, yo, I want to hear that beat too. But we gotta figure out a way to play your beat, because I want to hear that. Maybe later on.
Yeah.
All right, guys. So next up on the course of Neon Future Dinner, we got fun facts. Fun facts I found out about everyone here that you know, some of it's just like I had no idea about, which is really cool because I know you guys, but I don't know everything. Maluma, your name is really interesting. I never knew, you know, the story behind your name. Actually, please talk about that.
Oh, okay. Well, my mom's name is Margie, my dad's is Luis, and my sister's is Manuela. So I took the first two letters of each name and then I mixed them, and then that's how I created Maluma.
Maluma, right? That's dope.
That's fucking amazing.
That's really cool. It's gotta be the best story I ever heard for a station.
I don't know, bro. I feel like since I started my career, whatever it is, I feel like I've been doing all these things for them, you know, like, because I'm a very familiar person, right? I love being with them. And yeah, they're like my inspiration, bro. So that's why I decided to have in my artistic name.
That's great, man.
That's awesome, bro.
So your families, are they in your house too?
Yeah.
That's great. That's even better. Then you don't have to feel like...
I'm here with my mom and my sister. My dad, he lives like 5 minutes away from my house. But I mean, he was here like earlier. He came and he said hi, and then he left. He was like, no. I don't want to spend too much time over there. I'm going back to my house.
I think at this time is like when all of us, you know, just the human species, we're finally getting close with the families, because, you know, we can't work, we can't do anything besides that. So it's like we're spending more time like that, and that's the silver lining. You know, there's a lot of silver linings of what's going on during the quarantine.
Hey, you know what? Speaking of quarantine, I just realized I was digging in the crates of something that happened like 10 years ago today. We were kind of ahead of our time on it, yeah. Aoki, but this is the perfect freaking quarantine song. Check this out. Check this out.
All
right. perfect quarantine song, bro.
Let's hear it.
I'm in the house.
I'm in the house.
I'm in the house. I'm in the house. I'm in the house. I'm in the house. I'm in the house. I'm in the house. I'm in the house. I'm in the house.
What's crazy is, yo, in the video, bro, I had a freaking mask on.
Stop.
I had a mask on and goggles on, bro, and the song is called I'm in the House.
That's crazy. Like,
what the F?
Yo, we're gonna bring that back, man. The 2020 remix, the quarantine remix.
That's wow.
Yeah. I'm in the house, bro.
Yo, that's crazy.
10 years ago.
Yeah, that was
10 years ago, bro.
Wow.
That's because I used to go to this. I was in Australia, and I used to go to this club called Tank. And I'm like, yo, what the fuck is this electro shit? I met these DJs from Italy called the Crookers. I'm like, yo, what the fuck is this? And so I came back home and I was like, yo, DJ AM, rest in peace. You know, I was at this club and they were playing this electro shit. Have you heard of the Crookers? He's like, well, you want some shit like that in LA? You need to go to this club called Banana Splits on Sundays or Dimnac Tuesdays on Tuesdays. So I went, I walked in the fucking club. I'm like, yo, this is exactly the vibe that I saw in Australia. And I would go there religiously, like, yo, me and Red Food from LMF, yo, we would go there religiously, like, yo, check out what the fuck's going on, bro. This is the scene right here. This scene's the next scene. And so then I met Aoki, and then he's like, yo, I want to do a song with you. And I didn't know this was your first song. I didn't know it was his first song. I was like, yo, he sent me a beat. And I was like, I'm in the house. I'm in the motherfucking house. Do, 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 do. And then it's like, I saw this fucking culture getting ready to fucking take over the whole fucking planet. And from there, going to those clubs, we wrote Boom Boom Pow, and I got a feeling and started collaborating with all the freaking DJs and shit. And right now is a similar time, bro. The same thing that was happening in 2007, 8, 9. But the electro is happening in that Latin world, bro. That Latin world, that Maluma world, bro. That Maluma world, bro. That Maluma world, bro. That Maluma world, bro. Yo. Those dudes, it's similar, bro. It's similar, bro. This shit is freaking gigantic, global freaking monsters stomping the planet, man. That shit is freaking
awesome. Welcome to my world. You guys know that this is your world.
Yo,
two, whenever you guys want to come,
we gotta do a collab, all of us. Leia,
yeah, bro.
Maluma, Will, Nick Carter. Yo,
we should do a remake of the song. A remake.
Yo,
I'm in the house.
I'm in the house.
Let's do it. Yo, let's do it.
Bored in the house and I'm in the house bored. Bored in the house and I'm in the house bored. Bored in the house and I'm in the house bored.
No, but for real, we gotta do something off this, you know, like, that'll be sick.
Crazy.
That's dope. But I mean, Will, okay, let's just get back into the fun facts. So like, this is some really interesting stuff. I mean, especially for me, because I love space, I love all that kind of stuff. You sent a song, you're the first artist to send your music to Mars.
I worked with NASA on a song called, Reach for the Stars. Wow. So I have this robotics program. So in my neighborhood in East LA, I have like 720 Mexicanos that I work with, and we teach them robotics and computer science. And you know, and to get other people in other ghettos inspired about, you know, science and robotics and technology, I collaborated with NASA, and we did a song called Reach for the Stars. And we beamed it, we sent it to outer space with, we sent it to Mars on Curiosity's robot and beamed it back to Earth. Yeah, so that was like
crazy. That's dope.
That's dope.
That is, I you never think about stuff like that. But Will, you're always doing some next level tech, science, space shit, man. You're always on that note, man. That's awesome. Dope.
Damn, son.
So Agnez, so many different names I call you. A couple of different things. One, I am learning table tennis. And I'm learning ping pong.
Is that ping pong?
Ping pong, yeah.
Yeah.
And
I love ping pong.
Her mom is a pro table tennis player.
Yeah, she used to be a top 5 world rank. Table tennis.
Top 5 world rank.
I can't play, man. Like, I can't play for shit.
Why? Why? It's such a fun sport.
I don't know. Like, I can't play. Like, I was too intimidated by the thought of it. Like, she's just too good, man.
Yeah. Have you seen some the ping pong videos when they're like, you know, 50 feet back and they're just.
Yeah. And it's fast too. It's not like ping pong, you know? It's it's for real.
It's crazy. So I'm going to watch some videos of your mom now. So that was dope. But on another note with collabs, I love off the wall collabs. I love working with all different kinds of genres. But you got to work with someone I would never expect. Michael Bolton. That's something you never put together.
He's a legend.
No, he's a legend.
Legend.
No, he's a legend.
But, yeah, I mean, you know, like, I've always been the kind of artist who don't want to be boxed in. You know what I mean? Like, I don't want to be put in, you know, people little boxes. Because for me, like, that's what I love to do. I want to, like, push my boundaries. You know what I mean? Like, think something out of the box and to kind of, like, test it out. Like, test myself out and to challenge myself. So right. When I got that, I mean, like, because, of course, the fans were asking. I mean, the fans loved it. But it's just, you know, like, because a couple of years later after that, like, I had a feature with T.I. and Timbaland. And so I just feel like it's interesting.
Mix it up.
I love the song too. And yeah.
That's dope. I think that's so cool. Lay.
Yeah.
Lay, here, fun fact about you. Well, there's a couple. I mean, it's a lot, but there's a couple that I want to talk about. One is the cat story. This is really interesting. Yeah. Do you want to explain?
Yeah. I didn't know how to name it. So I just called the cat in Chinese.
So Lay bought a cat and then called it cat.
Yeah.
That's gangster, bro.
Yeah, that's genius, bro.
What were the other names though? What were the other like failed names?
So first of all, you guys need to know this cat was a homeless cat, and my father bought him in my father bought him, so just want the guy to catch some mouse.
Yeah.
But he always catch my leg. I don't know why, but he won't.
That's cool. But you also worked with one of my favorites of all time, Jackie Chan, in a movie. Well, I mean, that's goes to my heart. So what's it like to work with Jackie Chan?
Wow.
Wow. Yeah. Wow, it's amazing. Yeah. He just like a big brother and cares everybody. Yeah, and very kind.
Is he as nice as he is? Because he's always smiling. He's always goofy.
Yeah.
He's so funny. You know what I mean? You just want to give him a hug.
Yes. And you know, I learn a lot from him.
That's dope.
Yeah.
Nick, so this is pretty cool. So one of my favorite films, honestly, Edward Scissorhands. Tell us the story. You were in this movie, right?
Yeah, I was actually. So what I... That's me. that's what happens when you know you're auditioning all the time, and you try to audition for a major role and you don't get it, and then you end up as an extra in Swim Trunk.
I love it.
You know, in a major blockbuster movie.
I could tell that's you though, Nick.
But I was at least I could say that I was there. I was on set. You know, and I saw what they did to this entire town. They took like this place in Orlando, because I was like into acting and singing at the same time, and so basically they painted this entire town this like weird colors, you know, Tim Burton type colors and everything. Like, and I remember at the time being so young and thinking this is extreme. Like who is this person? Like this is one of the most imaginary. You know, imaginations in the world, you know, from Tim Burton himself.
I love that.
And now
you
look back at it and you're like, wow, like just to say that you were at least there. But I think I had to be like 10 years old or something, you know?
Yeah,
and I met the guys when I was 12.
Right.
So I joined the Backstreet Boys when I was 12. So it was like 2 years later. So that was my failed acting career right there. I became a Backstreet Boy, and that worked out a lot better for me.
Are you still doing any acting? Are you still?
Hey, thank you. What?
Are you still acting at all? Are you doing anything?
No,
like that,
I'm a horrible actor, and I realize it now. I accept it. I'm really not that good. I could sing a lot better than I can act. And look, I like it. I did this. You get to a point where you're like, okay, you like. I grew up like watching like movies like RoboCop and Aliens and like I'm all into science fiction type stuff, so and I wanted to act and stuff like that. I like zombie movies and anything science fiction and horror, and then and so I directed and wrote this movie a couple years ago. It was called Dead Seven, and I just got like a bunch of guys from NSYNC in it, and from O-Town, all the different boy bands. We all acted in this movie together, and
I gotta see this one.
It's the wackest movie you'll ever see. It was on Sci-Fi.
I got time, man. I got time.
But at least I could say that I directed and I wrote it and directed it. And there's Joey Fatone with me. AJ's this weird clown-looking guy.
Wow.
But it was fun,
That's dope, man.
I think it'd be cool to do something out in the desert. Maybe like, maybe out here in Vegas.
All right, well, I'll work on something with you. We'll be at 6 feet apart.
Maybe we should do something together. Hey, what were you doing out in the desert? Like you were doing, or were you like riding tanks or something recently?
He was
fucking shooting and saw him.
Yeah, man. My friend, he's got like the craziest guns. So sometimes I shoot off his guns, He's got some he had this crazy gun on top of a car. Okay, yeah. That was like for real. It was like what you see in like World War II or something. He's just like.
But that's what's crazy about Vegas, Like you literally go out in the middle of the desert. There's nothing out there. Look
That's real. I'm not kidding you. That gun's real. I mean, I couldn't believe you could drive that down the street. I had earplugs in and I was covering my head because it was so loud. It was very scary. I'll tell you that. It was very, very scary. All right, guys, let's move on to the next course of Neon Future Dinner. It's called Internet Gems, and it's basically all the amazing fans that all of us have sent in some videos, sent in photos of what's keeping them going, entertained while we are
bored in the house, and I'm in the house bored.
So let's play some of these. These are some fun clips that we just kind of found. All right.
Nice.
So, what this dude right here, he's either Mortal Kombat final boss or just some crazy guy.
Honestly, dude, is he really just trying to keep people away from him?
I don't know if that really works. He doesn't have a mask on, but that dude's fucking funny. Okay. Who hasn't watched Tiger King?
Harold Baskin.
Who hasn't watched Tiger King? We all know what this is, but that's just funny. Carol Baskin looks
really
like,
creepy, to be quite honest.
As a baby, kind of looks like her.
It's very disturbing.
This is very disturbing. I love the stance on this old lady. She's just like, don't fuck with me.
That's art.
It is art. I mean, just like the way that the toilet paper rolls were structured. Love it. Should be a painter.
That's the shit. Will, I need you.
I like this one.
Good one.
This one's like, this is like what the old English judges used to look like, right? But they're their wigs. Well, happy Easter, guys.
Oh, I see
happy
it.
Happy Easter.
I see it. I see it. Everyone knows him.
All right.
That's cool.
Wow.
I can't tell if that's something that Benny Hahn is
playing.
Here we go.
Hey there, all you cool cats and kittens. This is Carol from Big Cat Rescue. Howard, please stop talking over my video. Thank you. This is Carol from Big Cat Rescue. I just wanted to let you know that they are reopening the case that said that I killed my husband, which is insane. So yeah, everything's okay here. Everything's fine.
Carol Baskerville will never end.
You know, my husband and I are having great sex. Howard!
Oh yeah, okay, the Tussie Slide. You guys have done a Tussie Slide? Every day with it. I'm gonna show you how to get it. It go right foot up, left foot slide, left foot up. Uh-oh. That didn't happen to me. I actually did a Tussie Slide. I'm gonna, I gotta post it up because I'm pretty proud of it. But I had a nice carpet I could work on, so.
I'ma show you how to get it. It go right foot up, left foot slide, left foot up.
Oh, this one's my favorite
slide. Basically, I'm saying either way, we about to slide. You can't let this one slide. I'ma show you how to get it.
With the carpet, you can do the slide. It's not a problem. All right, guys, we are at the last course of Neon Future Dinner. Thanks for joining me. It's just crazy times right now. Crazy times. Quarantine. And I think the main question is like, how long is this gonna go for? You know, like I say, like a month ago, I was thinking that my summer shows were still gonna be going on because I had, you know,
my God,
shows like Tomorrowland was like, okay, we could maybe save Tomorrowland in the summer and in July, August shows are potentially gonna be saved. But like, what do you guys think? Actually, you know, I know we all had to cancel tours. And it's just like that question I've been asking all my friends, like, when are we going to get back on stage? When are we touring? Like,
I'm worried, bro. For real, I miss touring.
Yeah.
You know, like, I was like almost touring for 8 years. You know, I didn't rest, not even 1 year. And then everything stopped, you know. And I'm worried, you know, as you just get used to that life. It's a lifestyle. Being on stage, rehearsals. You guys already know how it is. So it's like, I'm very worried because I really miss my career. You know, like it's cool to stay at home and whatever I said before, but I really feel like, fuck man, I want to sing, you know?
Yeah.
I had to postpone the whole tour, the European tour. I was in the middle of it. And then when everything stopped, imagine everybody, they got the tickets. Thank God. A lot of the shows they were sold out, right? But it feels bad, you know, just to think that you don't know when you're gonna be on stage again. So I don't know. For me, to be honest, I don't think that this year I'm gonna perform. I don't know. I don't see it because people at home they're afraid, you know, even when they find the cure or whatever it is. People they're not gonna go out to a show. And there's another thing is that the economy is frozen right now. So people they're saving their money.
Yeah.
You know, they're not gonna go to fucking show, you know, because they have to save their money to eat because you know when you're gonna go to work again. So I don't know. I would say like maybe next year, January, February. The most important thing is to stay healthy.
Yeah.
You know. That the work or whatever, the shows, whatever it is, they're going to come, the work, everything, you know, that's going to be okay. But the most important thing for me and all the people that is watching right now is staying at home and being conscious of the whole situation and all the things that we're living right now.
If that's...
Yeah, it'll be like this. It'll be like this till summer 2021. If there's going to be...
Wow.
And even then, people are going to be cautious about going out. Because you're going to have this summer is shut down and maybe in August things will start looking better. And then you have December that comes right after that, November, December, January, then it's winter again.
Yeah. Yeah.
But then like, whatever, then that virus might pop up.
Right. Right. Right.
So people will, you know, and then we'll, you know, the virus probably would have morphed and gotten stronger or weaker, we don't know. And it's safe to say 2021 summer is probably when we're going to have a little bit of what it used to be. Yeah. So until then, it's going to take like very imaginative people to dream up new ways to entertain people, new ways to inspire folks, you know, because, you know, all the lives that are happening right now, that's great. But what needs to happen between now and then is, you know, better audio quality so people have a richer experience, and a way for people to make a living out of entertaining folks like this. So until then, it's going to take the dreamers to dream up new ways. But it's not going to be, we're not going to see the light at the end of the tunnel until 2021.
Yeah. Well, it is what it is.
Yeah. You know, I
get better.
Go ahead, Le.
Yeah. I hope things get better.
Yeah.
As an artist, I too missing doing concerts. So I think more concerts will be online.
Right. Yeah, that's for sure. That's definitely for sure. I mean, I watch yours, Aggie.
I think it's an opportunity for us to, you know, as a world, to self, to reflect on ourselves as well. You know, to really just, you know, look deep within ourselves, like Will just said, you know, come up with new innovations and new things that can change the landscape in the meantime while we're all being responsible, because that's really what it's all about. We have to be responsible. For not just ourselves, but for one another. And that's the thing about artists and the entertainment business. You know, we live we work in a business where, you know, we are responsible for, you know, especially when it comes to touring, you know, massive amounts of people in one setting. And so, you know, that leaves you with just a, you know, you don't know what's going to happen kind of feeling. So in the meantime, you can sit back home and sort of just try to reflect and you know, love ones tight and just really kind of like, I don't know if you believe, but you know, lean on God a little bit. You know what I mean? Lean on God.
Of course. Faith, bro.
Yeah.
Keep your faith.
You know,
shit, but I miss it for real. Oof.
I know. I miss it so much.
Difficult. Yeah.
I miss it so
just,
much.
Just stop and that's it. Boom.
It's crazy. Yeah, it really is. You know, I got pulled off tour as well. It's just like, I'm like, oh, but I can go back and play, I think, you know, and then like, I mean, 3 weeks ago, I thought completely differently. 4 weeks ago, you know, however long that was. But now it's like, you know, you're afraid to leave the house.
Yeah, Steve, sorry.
No, go ahead. I mean, it's crazy. Like, because we're all on the road. We're all playing in front of tons of people all the time. That's what we do. That's what we live for, you know?
Yeah. I mean, I kind of feel guilty for the, you know, for the fans too, because I kept telling them, hey, like the album's done, you know, and it's about to be out in March or April. And you know how it is, Steve. Like sometimes you write a record, it's for, you know, it's summer records.
Yeah.
But then, like summer's going done, out. Then, you know what I mean? Then when are you going to release that? And then even if you release it this year, then you know what I mean? Like, it's just different because you want to be out there on stage and see their, you know, their reaction to it, whether they like it or not, whether they fuck with it or not. You know what I mean? So,
I think it's interesting because I don't know if you guys are feeling it, but everyone's, you know, while you're quarantined and you're back home, you know, and you're just, you know, you're confined. You know, there's millions and millions of people out there that feel the exact same way, you know, and I think maybe the light at the end of the tunnel will be that, you know, for all those fans and people who want, you know, if it's 6 months from now, if it's, you know, a year from now, whatever it is, we're going to be there as entertainers for them in the end. You're going to be there with that album. You know, we're going to be there with, you know, Steve's going to be there with, you know, the clubs, we're going to be there again for them so that they can have an opportunity. Cause I feel like, you know, when it does finally the dam breaks, they're going to want to be entertained and we're going to be there for our fans. And we're going to be there for the people who want to have a break from all this stuff that they've been going through for years. So.
And also,
we need it too, you know?
Yeah. And also Steve, like this conversation right here, I just feel like this is because of the self quarantine. Otherwise, like we would just be, you know, wherever we want to be or wherever we would be, but we wouldn't be like here in this having this conversation together. So that's, you know, that's
for sure.
Yes.
That's crazy. I do want to mention this because it was really interesting. Like the protocols that may have to take place in order for people to go into a gathering space. You know, so before, let's say like you do like a litmus test of like 100 people, not a festival, but like a small show or 50 people. You'd have to figure out what you could do to make sure those people are safe. Because at some point, we're going to have to get to this point of testing out the small gatherings or small shows or right. Like, you know, if you put on a sports, like a something with sports and they're actually going to show sports, right? Soccer or football. There's going to be 200 people there. Yeah, exactly. 200 people there that are the coaches and the players. And it's already 200 people in one little area. So how are they going to test them? One of the conversations I had was, you know, obviously you have the swab tests that can test if you're positive or negative, but now there's these finger prick tests that you can find out in 3 minutes and it's 99% accurate. So I just feel like, I think from now on, I mean, this is all in theory, but you can imagine them just pricking everyone and going, okay, you're negative. Mm-hmm. Okay. You can go in negative. You can go in. And then like it's a longer process, but you know,
it's crazy, bro. It's crazy. But I think that after this darkness, you know, that we live in, I think that beautiful things are coming too. You know, all this shit that is happening for a reason, and the light is gonna come, bro. You know, like there's not another way to see it. So
yeah,
you guys are a great company. Staying out home.
my fellow entertainers, I love you guys. You know,
thank you guys
so much for being a part of this.
This was incredible, honestly. Incredible. Bring everyone together. Appreciate it. This is the first Neon Future Dinner. We did it together.
Neon Future Dinner.
I love you guys. You guys are awesome.
Love you, brother.
I'm gonna start doing.
Hey Maluma.
Yo.
Put your finger down. Because this is the way we're gonna have to shake hands before it. If you put your finger down to my finger. No, the other way. Go down the camera like this.
What do you mean?
Because look. Like that, like this. Look. So if you look like that,
yeah,
you touch down and I touch up.
Okay,
this.
Got it. Oh, okay, I get it.
All right, let's all do it.
Steve, go up.
I'm going up.
Go up.
All right.
And go up. There you go.
Shit, all right. Oh, here. There it is. Yo, this is dope.
Good job, Will.
Hey, thank you guys.
I love you guys.
Yeah, all right, guys. See you later, bro.
Take it easy.
Love you later. Love you.
Thanks for the time and everything.
Yeah, thanks so much, guys.
Future dinner.
Ciao, papa.
Hi, brother.
In the neon future, we are searching into the unknown, exploring ever-expanding frontier, trying to find answers, to understand hope, to find the truth of life, beyond life, after life. Become closer to God. Inside the matrix, the clock keeps ticking and ticking until we reach zero. Yet we constantly keep pursuing, we keep exploring and transforming. Evolving, progressing, surviving, coming closer and closer and closer for a final moment. are searching into the unknown.
Future.